The last thing I want to do after filing stories, producing online content all day, is go to an event where I'm expected to write some stories and produce some online content about it. Unless there's wine involved or it's for someone I admire. In this case, it's both. The Sonoma Valley Museum of Art is hosting the Cultural Arts Council and Commission of Sonoma's Treasure Artist of the Year, who happens to be costume designer Linda Rawls. Now, I dig Linda because once upon a time, this very coat that I'm wearing here, this black velvet number, was once nearly destroyed beyond all recognition in a freak parking accident many Halloweens ago. But she fixed it for me. So tonight, I'm going to work in her honor at the museum.
What makes a costume designer? Is it having historical knowledge, or is it just pure aesthetics?
Well, you need to have the aesthetics, and if you're going to do it well, you've got to do your research. You can't ever let the history get ahead of the play, you know, that still you're still working to express the director's vision for the piece of work that you're doing. So it's one of those things, you have to take somebody else's work, somebody else's ideas, and then make it fit.
And interpret them as here, yeah. And then make them fit an actual actor.
Yes. Right, and the actor, and that's actually the easiest part, is making an individual costume. What you're really doing, if you're a good costumer, is you're painting a picture on stage that's helping to tell the story.
That's well put.
And that's what we're doing. It's not the single, because a seamstress can make the costume you design, but it's the whole picture that you're designing. So you have very large paint strokes.
Right.